The following contest is an elimination match.
Really? There's a glitch. Boy, anyway, guys. Hello, guys. Unicorns 9 here. Welcome to a very special episode of Apex Wrestling. This is a match that I've been trying to do. So, we're going to get this going. I had to take out a couple of wrestlers, but I did it based on how active the wrestlers were. I took out two people. I took out Seth Bates and one half of the Young Brothers. I took out Seth Bates because he's not really saying anything. And I took out Kyle Young because his brother is still in the tournament. So, yeah. So this will be a 10-man over-the-top rope battle royal. The winner will take my spot, Lee Anderson.
And from Cherry Hill, New Jersey, weighing in at 218 pounds, Elliot Collins.
So here's the deal. I, as some of you may know, I, Lee Anderson, have decided to take a little bit of a break from the ring. And I've made my intentions clear on when my return match will be. And it's already, at this point, it may be confirmed to be that match, or if Grand Prix Wrestling decides to, I'll let them give me a match on at their Rage pay-per-view as a pre-show type of match. You know, get the crowd going. You know, get the crowd hype as fuck. But Right now, we are doing a 10-man battle royal, where the winner of this battle royal will be determined by where the winner of this battle royal will take my spot in the tournament. We're only in our semifinal, but I wanted to do this match just to get it out of the way, and so I don't forget about it later on. So we have Elliot Collins as the number one entrant, and who will be number two?
Weighing in at 257 pounds, the Dragon, Daniel Storm.
The Black Dragon, Daniel Storm, number two in this battle royal. He's probably, if I can see his lips are moving, so if I had to take a wild guess, he's probably talking a little bit of smack toward Elliot Collins as he makes his way to the ring. But here he is, Daniel Storm, number two. Let's see, so whoever gets eliminated first, the other person will automatically last the longest. So here are the rules. Every 60 seconds, every 90 seconds, a new wrestler will enter this ring. And this will continue until all 10 superstars have entered the ring. We already have two here, so the 90-second process will be restarted 8 times. Oh, nice lead from Collins. So this will be an interesting showing, as it only takes 8 wrestlers to fill up this ring now. So if 8 wrestlers do fill in the ring,
competitor has been eliminated.
Oh my God! Daniel Storm just got eliminated by Elliot Collins. Oh, good lord. Is this going to be a sign of things to come for Collins right now as we hit number three? And it's Omari Williams, the man behind Ultimate Pro Wrestling. Oh, and already a lot. Elliot Collins already going crazy on these people. And Omari this time caught him. So Omari may actually prove to be a bigger challenge than Daniel Storm was just a minute ago, who just got eliminated. And Elliot Collins almost met the same fate, but Omari is still persistent on trying to get him eliminated. but Elliot Collins goes right at the lane and has a backstabber. Now it looks Owen. But then Collins was going to try to go for something yet again. Omari, though, counted it into a nice powerbomb. Omari Williams, Elliot Collins, this would be an interesting match to do in the future, if you ask me. I say basically anybody in this battle royal deserved this opportunity. Oh, and Elliot! Oh! Omari Williams almost met the same exact fate as Daniel Storm did, getting eliminated by being thrown over the top rope. Omari needs to be careful now. Otherwise, he may be just as quickly eliminated as Storm was. And now we are waiting the arrival of number 4. Who is it gonna be? Oh, and it's the man with the spear out of nowhere, Brad Skeens. This man, I'm not gonna lie. Every time I see Brad Skeens now, I still remember that particular moment when he just taunted and he got super kicked. I'm never gonna let Brad Skeens live that down every time I see him. Every time he wins a match, I'm always gonna bring that up, so you better be prepared. Smack while Omari doing some hard work trying to get Skeens coming. Oh, look at this double team. Skeens and Collins working together. But that was only for just a short second. And a super kick! A neat super kick to Brad Skeens while he's kneeling down. That's going to leave a mark. And now Collins, what's he going for here? Spinning neck breaker. And Omari, though, comes right back with a backbreaker right over the knee. Now Omari, this is the thing about Omari. He doesn't want to do things quickly. He wants to destroy his opponent systematically before he eliminates them. And number 5, Ace Porter. I haven't seen much of this man to say anything, so... maybe we'll see. Collins got eliminated. So after 2 eliminations, Elliot Collins is eliminated. And now it's Ace Porter, Brad Skeens, and Omari Williams. One in a 3-way until our next participant comes out to round 2. One of these 3 men gets eliminated. And Ace Porter just taunted to the ground. And look at him standing behind the scenes. He's waiting for his moment to step up. And Skeens went for a belly to belly. Omari, though, counted him. And now Ace Porter going to get involved. Or at least it looked like he was. Oh, now Skeens may be in trouble. Skeens is eliminated. And now Ace Porter going to work on Omari, who goes right over the top rope. Oh, and a backhand. The backhand shot from Porter. Nice one there. Omari, elbow right to the face. A discus elbow or a discus clothesline. I couldn't tell which was which, but it looked like an elbow. Either way, Omari Williams now going for a powerbomb, and he gets it into a cutter. And now Williams, looks like he's about done with it. Oh no, the Porter says no. Six, Frosty, the Frost Man, James Frost right there. Hashtag say Frosty going wild on Twitter. I wish. Hashtag stay Frosty. Hold on a second. We have a dog. Trying to eliminate James Frost, but Frost is the freshest man out of them, so it's going to be difficult trying to eliminate him. all my opponent, look at the size of opponent. I mean, ever since the opening match, ever since he came out, his size has impressed me. I mean, it's really his size and the fact that he's just also wickedly powerful. Like, good God Almighty, man. Now Porter, oh, into a brainbuster for Williams. Now Williams.
Strength of Williams. That is incredible.
pissed off. But that's what happens when you get pissed off. You just start getting pissed off. This kind of crap happens to you. Maximus going right back to work on K-Dog after he got up some time ago. And there's the super kick! And Williams is finally eliminated! Oh, and Maximus may be following soon here. And he keeps messing up with a nice middle rope Hamat. Okay, I know it's a kick. I think it was like a karate kick or karate. I don't know what the actual name of that kick is. Don't sue me. Oh, he dabbing! Maximus just dabs after taking down K-Dog. Don't be dabbing until after you win your match, Maximus. Oh, no. Oh, and Maximus got karma! Maximus just got eliminated after he dabbed. What? Oh my god, and Robert Hall going back into this. But K-Dog, this is a practical rematch between these two. But over the top rope rules instead of an actual pinfall or submission. And K-Dog just blasted. Just as he was entering the ring, K-Dog blasted Robert Hall with a nice kick. Uh-oh. Oh, and there's a kick. Oh man, a Kinshasa. Oh, that looks like K-Dog. Oh, K-Dog. Oh, I knew what he was trying to go for. He was trying to take him to the ropes just so he can eliminate him quickly. Trying to eliminate him quickly, but that's not going to happen when you're a freshman. Neil Cutter! And a cutter right to Robert Hall. And there's a swinging net breaker. That may have just done it right there. That may have just been enough to take Robert Hall out, but K-Dog is not done. K-Dog has some apparently in his mind has some unfinished business with Robert Hall after Hall eliminated him in the first round of this tournament. But the question is, will K-Dog get his payback, or will Robert Hall once again come out on top in this battle royal? Close, really, at this point, and Williams may have him, or not Williams, K-Dog, I'm sorry, K-Dog may have Robert Hall now. Okay, why the hell is K-Dog's arm under the bottom, under the top rope? I don't get it. But anyway, after a little bit of time between these two, they're finally ready. Round two, boys, let's get going. Oh, and K-Dog just about blocked whatever Robert Hall had coming. Oh, good God, the power, the strength of that overhead belly to belly. Now Robert Hall, he needs to get back into things if he wants to walk out the winner of this battle royal. Oh, he's going to try to eliminate K-Dog again. Oh, will he do it? Oh, no, he couldn't. He couldn't do it. He's going to try to eliminate him again, though. But K-Dog goes right at the arm. Robert Hall decides to get away before he does any more damage to that leg. With any more shots to it. Once again, K-Dog Kato trying to stay in things, but he stays in after a couple of shots of him in the lane. Oh, but Kato into! Into a nice DDT, but now he's got it. Uh-oh. Oh, and it's going to be good for Robin Hall. Oh, man! Face first into the ring. Oh, a nice drop to a whole count of my hole. And look at these two. Uh-oh. Oh, these two are fighting it. This is like Royal Rumble 2005 all over again. I haven't actually seen it. I don't know. Oh! Oh, look at Kato! Robert Hart just got a soldier punch! And Kato can't believe it! And now Robert Hall once again going for the elimination. Three times he's gone for this elimination, but three times it does not work. Oh, what a shot from Hall there, though. That was a nice shot, and now Hall trying to wear down Kato enough to eliminate him. Kato just wants some payback. That's what's keeping Kato going. It's nothing but payback for Robert Hall. He wants to destroy Robert Hall. He wants to damage anything he wants. And there he is. Kato is the winner of this battle royal. After a hard fought back and forth battle between Kato and Robert Hall, Kato gets the opportunity to reclaim, to go after the gold.
Here is your winner, Kato.
And Kato, he's ready. It's not WrestleMania, but he is ready. He is going to be taking my spot in the tournament, and I hope he is prepared for his opponent.